So good morning everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about measurement of screw thread. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about two wire method. Okay, so two wire method which can be used to measure the effective diameter of the threads. So normally people know that exactly in the effective diameter that the pitch the thread dia as well as the empty space it will be equal. Okay, that is which one effective diameter, how to measure the effective diameter. So for that we are using this two wire method. The two wire method, so normally there are two wires, it will be placed, two wires or two cylindrical ball, it will be placed over here. If you check over here the wire dia, we can take it as in terms of D. So here they are going to make it as in the axis of the wire is taking as a O. Wherever the wire it will be met with the flank, that exactly we are going to take D and E over here. Then actually the lowest part of the wire is A, we are going to take exactly that straight line where it will be cuts the flank, we are taking C and B over here. And comes into the angle from the flank to the flank angle, usually we are going to take theta by 2. Okay, so then comes into here wherever it will be met, actually that is we are going to take E where it will be going to start. Then height we are going to take in terms of H. Okay, so here E is the effective diameter of the screw thrust. E is the effective, this is the effective diameter of the screw threads, and H is the dimension over wires. Okay, so this is the H is the dimension over wires, and D is the, already people know that diameter of the wire. Then effective diameter of the screw thread is given, E is equal to Y plus P. So effective diameter of the screw thread, E is equal to Y plus P, they are given over here. Okay, then comes into the next one where P is the pitch value. This will be dependent on the pitch of the thread and wire diameter D. So it can be derived P is equal to minus 0.866 P minus small d. So this will become 0.09605 P into 1.657D. So this will be for white bus thread, and 0.66P minus D is the metric thread. Now from the figure, E is equal to Y plus AQ. Okay, from the figure E is equal to Y plus AQ. So here what is the AQ value? So A Q, this is the one. So normally E is equal to, we can write Y plus A into Q. So this distance is called as Q. Okay, so then comes into the next step. Consider a triangle OEG. So this is the triangle OEG. So here sine theta by 2. So sine theta by 2 it will becomes OE by OG. So OE by OG. So this is the one, OE by OG, opposite side by hypotenuse side. So it will become, so that OG is equal to OE into cosecant theta by 2, while it will go other side, it will becomes as a 1 by sine theta. So directly we are going to take this as a cosecant theta. Then comes into OG is equal to, so the OE value we are going to take, OE value we are going to take. So normally from mid to OE is coming, no? So everywhere it will becomes as a D by 2. So that here OE value we are going to take as a D by 2 into cosecant theta by 2. Now consider the triangle QCG. So this is the QCG. So where it will becomes Q C and G. So this is the QCG. Previously we are taking as a OEG. So that is the OEG we are took. Now we are going to take Q, C, G. Okay. So Q, C, G. So in that tan theta by 2. So tan theta by 2 is equal to Q, C by Q, G. So Q, C by Q, G. Opposite side by adjacent side. Okay. That is the tan theta by 2. So it will becomes QC by QG. So QG is equal to QC into cot theta by 2. So now BC is equal to half into pitch. So what is the BC? BC. So in the diagram we will see BC is equal to, so half into pitch. So this is the value is called half into pitch. So half into P. So P is equal to QC. So P is equal to half into P means QC. Exactly centrally Q is placed. So from here to here the distances we are going to take as a Q into C. Now QC is equal to half into BC. Okay. So QC is equal to half into BC. So this equation will become P by 4. Okay. So this will be P by 4. So QG is equal to QC value you can substitute over here. QG is equal to P by 4 cot theta by 2. So from the figure OG is equal to OA plus OG. OG is equal to, so OG plus is equal to OA plus AG. Okay, that is the thing they have written over here. OA plus OG. Okay, so now AG is equal to OG minus OA. So because OG value also we know, OA value also we know. Okay, so OG value is a d by 2 cosecant theta by 2 minus OA value is a d by 2. So while simplifying it, this will becomes d by 2 into cosecant theta by 2 minus 1. Then QG, what is the, where is the QG? So the here the QG value we can going to write like this. QA into AG. So which is the QA? QA into AG. Okay. So now QA value is equal to QG minus AG. So here we are simplifying that we are going to get P by 4 cot theta by 2 minus D by 2 cosecant theta by 2 minus 1. Okay. So AQ is the half of the pitch value. So that P is equal to 2 AQ. So AQ value you can substitute over here. So the equation will become P by 2 cot theta by 2 minus D cosecant theta by 2 minus 1. Suppose this is the formula. So in this formula, suppose depends upon the this one, depends upon the angle. Okay, so theta is equal to 60 degree means P is equal to, that means included angle or thread angle 60 degree means we can substitute over here. Finally the this one we are going to get P is equal to 0.866 P minus D. So this is the thing we have discussed in the first slide. Here P is equal to 0.866 P minus D. Same like another one, 55 degree. So 55 degree means 0.9065. So that value you can substitute, we are going to get theta is equal to 55 degree. Okay, so P by 2 in this formula you can substitute, we are getting as this is the answer. So normally whitewash thread we are going to take a thread angle is 55 degree. Metric thread we are going to take as metric angle thread, angle of the metric thread is the 60 degree, angle of the whitewash thread is the 55 degree. So there P, the affected P is going to multiply with help of this form. Okay, this is about the two wires method. If you are using the two wires in the opposite direction, that is the two wires method. Okay, thank you.